What's up, everyone? It's your boy NorNrad89 here, bringing you another rad movie review today. Today we're going to be talking about Don't Tell a Soul, a new thriller I just recently caught on the TV. I wanted to do a review on it, drop it, tell you what I thought about it. So stick around, and before we get to the review, consider dropping a like and hitting that subscribe button so you can stay up to date on all the content I put out. Also, I'll have a link in my description on my Twitter handle so you can follow me there too. Let's get down to this rad movie review. Roll it. So, Don't Tell a Soul is a new thriller I caught on the TV starring Rainn Wilson, most people best known for Dwight from The Office, and Jack Dylan Grazer, I think is that's how you say his last name. He's from It Chapter 1 and It Chapter 2. And it's a movie that's centered on two brothers who steal money from a house that's being fumigated, so it's like all abandoned, no one's living in it right now at the moment, and they steal money from the house. And while they're doing that, as they're on their escape outside of the house, a security guard happens to see them, starts chasing them through the woods, and as he's chasing them, he falls down a well, and the kids decide to leave him there, the two brothers. But then, of course, the younger brother is definitely more into we have to kind of help this man, or more into like, oh, what happened to him? Like, we need to figure out. So that's what the center of the story is, core is about. So let's get down to talking about the positives of this film. So right off the bat, positives for me, one of the core positives is going to be the actors. The cast is a very good, small-time, well-known cast. It's not like a great celebrity cast, but it's cast that you will know, and it's actors that deliver on their roles very good, and they have like such a great vibe throughout the film. And it's one of those movies that doesn't have like a ton of action at all, and it's very paced, like very slow in the pacing of the story, but the actors do such a good job of just keeping you interested in this world, and it's little tidbits of things throughout the movie that kind of just kind of make you more interested and more interested, and you're like, whoa, like this is something I want to watch, you know what I mean? Like as I was watching it, there was kind of a point where I was like, I'm gonna get bored. I feel like I'm gonna get bored in this film, but it didn't really happen. Like I didn't really get super bored or nothing like that. Like I said, it has a very slow pace, but the actors do such a good job of just keeping you entertained and in this world and everything. Also, I love the fact that it's a great kind of small budget indie film. The director like did a very good job of keeping this film cheap and using like so many good like different shots of different the same street, but shooting it in different ways when the kids come out of their house or when they're coming home, and just making every locale that's the same look different by shooting it in a different fashion. It's a very good way, and you can tell the director has a good eye for cinematography and he knows what he's doing and all that kind of stuff. So I liked the storytelling and the cinematography with the camera. That did very well as good too. And it's a cool story because it's one of those stories that like it kind of has an antagonist, but not really. It's like one of those stories that it's just about real people. It's just about people that it's a story that could have happened or a true story, you know what I mean? So it feels that way. It doesn't feel like there's a true antagonist or protagonist. There's a main character we follow through the film and we follow his eyes and like see everything through his way and everything, but the core of the film, I don't see it like an actual true antagonist. There is a character, his older brother, who's, if you could think of all the most evil siblings in any movie ever, like that's, so he's kind of like that. So you can kind of view him as an antagonist, and it's more of like brother overcoming brother, like fighting for that, who's gonna be kind of the top dog when the dad's not around anymore because their dad passed away. So it's kind of like who's the man in the house kind of now, right at that moment. That's what's going on. And Mina Savari plays their mother, and she's sick and she has cancer, so she can't really do a lot. So it's definitely up to these two boys to kind of take care of the house and figure out what's going to be happening from now on for their lives. So it's really a struggle at the core about two brothers and their relationship and everything. And even at the beginning of the movie, there's a Jane Austen quote from a book about brothers are strange creatures. So it's definitely, that's the real core central story that it focuses on, but it has all this other kind of stuff wrapped around it. Rainn Wilson plays a really good act of like Dwight. We know him as Dwight. He's really great as the security guard that falls down the well, and just his interactions with the kids and stuff, because he has, you're asking him to do kind of a lot when he's stuck in just like that well. A lot of the delivery and the way he does his lines is how he's going to capture you, and he does a really good job of keeping you interested in the movie and everything. So let's get down to talking about the negatives of this movie. And as for me, the negatives is you could definitely tell for me it felt like it was a beginning writer. Like it was someone that hadn't written a lot of movies, or wasn't into writing a lot. It definitely felt like a beginning writer. It felt like the actors definitely carried this movie for sure. If it wasn't for the certain cast that they got in this film, it wouldn't be that interesting, and it definitely would have been a lot of lower score for me for sure. So I felt like the writing was very kind of basic. It was good, but it was better, more on the delivery of the lines. That's what I thought did better. Also, they do go a long stretch and a long way of trying to make his brother, the older brother, like this very sadistic, evil kind of character that's abusive and just the worst big brother you can think of. Like, that's how he is. And they go a long way on like trying to make him such a bad guy and everything. And it's like, it's believable, but kind of unbelievable at the same time. So when there's a certain point at the end, like I said, I don't want to spoil it because this is a non-spoiler review, but there's a certain point at the end, there's a certain reveal, certain things happen, and it doesn't land as good or land that well for me because of the way they portrayed the brother throughout the entire movie, basically. And it also has a very short runtime. It's 1 hour and 23 minutes. I could have done with maybe 10, 15 more minutes to maybe flesh out the characters a little more. Like, we could have got a little more in depth about his older brother, Matt, instead of the younger brother, Joey. We follow most of the stuff is through Joey's eyes. We see everything through his experience. And if we would have got maybe kind of a dual storyline telling of Matt's side and Joey's side, maybe it would have been, for me, it would have been a better movie. It would have made the characters feel even more three-dimensional and even more realistic, and I think that would have served the film better. But because of the way they portrayed the brother, there's a certain ending thing that doesn't land very well for me. And as I said, the writing, I don't think the writing was that great in this film. It's okay, but it's not that great. But overall, I did still have a really good time with it. It was a thriller that caught my eye. I saw the trailer for it, and then I saw it on the TV to order. So I was like, wow, I'm just going to order this and check this out. So I watched it last night, and I was thoroughly entertained with it. I kept my entertaining, or kept my in intention, bleh, if I could speak. It kept my attention, and I did have a good time with it, mainly, like I said, because of the actors. And I really did like that small budget indie feel for it, because it did feel very realistic, like, and down home, like gritty kind of feel to it. So I really did like that as a beginning and positives for the movie. So overall, in my book, this movie is gonna get a 7 out of 10. Don't tell a soul. I definitely recommend it as a rent for sure. You can order it on DirecTV. I have it, and I'd have to check. I don't know if it's on any others. It might be on HBO Max or some other services, but for me, it was on my DirecTV on the TV to order. And I definitely did have a good entertaining time with it. I think you guys would like it. And like I said, definitely check it out. Let me know what you think. Hit me up in the comment section. I would love to hear from all of you. And hit me up on Twitter or on Discord. I'm always there. Give me a shout out. Have a good day, guys. Peace out.